you could spend a moment with some remarkable people and discover what their life sounds like, what would you ask? Welcome to Are We On Air? An audio encounter. I'm Arman and each episode will feature one conversation with an inspiring friend of mine who will share with us the soundtrack to their life. Welcome back to season two of Are We On Air? I am your show's host, Arman Nafei, and I'm very excited to kick off the new season with one of the biggest pop stars of today. Her name is Dua Lipa. Dua and I had a fun little chat exactly a year ago in Los Angeles at the Chateau, pre-pandemic, and it took us exactly 1 year to reconnect. And what a year it's been for her. From Grammy nominations for her album Future Nostalgia, to the cover of the Rolling Stone magazine, to a record-breaking 8 million views for her livestream concert 2054. We discovered her live soundtrack from her Albanian roots all the way to her collaboration with Madonna and our newfound mantra for 2021, Radical Optimism. I hope you enjoy. Dua.
Hi.
It's been a year.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. It's nice to see you, although from a distance, but it's a pleasure nonetheless.
Always, always. I mean, it's literally, I think a year ago, last time I saw you at the Chateau.
Oh my God. Yeah, it feels like that. And I'm still here.
And you're still there. I love that you're at the Chateau right now and I'm not. But it's okay. I mean, different world. I mean, I gave you a tour of the club, you know?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I know, it was like gearing up to open, and I guess everything's at a standstill now, but hopefully soon we'll be back out and dancing. I think that's what everybody wants, right?
I'm dying.
Yeah.
I'm literally, I mean, to quote James Brown, I got ants in my pants and I need to dance, you know?
I think everyone collectively is feeling that vibe.
But we were talking about your back then upcoming new album, which was a disco-infused record,
yeah.
Future Nostalgia. And now it's out and you're killing it. Oh. I'm so proud of you. What a year you've had.
Oh, thank you so much. It's been good. You know, despite everything, I'm so happy that I just got to put music out this time and I just kept pushing. And I was like, you know what? No matter what, I'm still going to do videos, even if they have to be animated for a short period of time. Luckily, I only had to do one animated video. But it was all fun, part of the process, you know, everybody's just kind of picking it up and learning and getting used to this new normal. So blessing and a curse, I suppose.
Blessing and a curse. Well, one of the blessings that I came up with was this beautiful interview series called Are We On Air? Because I meet wonderful people like yourself.
Oh.
And I believe that everybody has a soundtrack to their life. And me, of course, being the music guy, I thought, why not ask those lovely people about the soundtrack to their life?
Love it.
And here we are.
Love it. Thanks for having me.
Of course, my pleasure. So, to begin with, What's your earliest significant musical memory that shaped you as an artist?
Well, I guess my earliest memory that shaped me as an artist is really, you know, listening to music with my parents, writing songs at home. Like I wrote my first song. No, I can't say it was like a song, a full song. It was like a little chorus when I was about 4 or 5 years old. It was an Albanian and it was a song that I wrote for my mum. And it's basically like, when I grow up, can I borrow your dress? When I grow up, can I wear your shoes? When I grow up, can I be as pretty as you? And it was just something that I would just sing. It was just something playful, but it was like the first kind of memory of actually writing music and just doing something like silly and fun with it. That it's just, I guess it's just been such a massive part of my life. My family's really musical. So it was, I think, quite a natural gradient that I went into this as like a career field, I suppose.
So you would say that your Albanian background, your heritage, had a big influence,
absolutely,
on who you are, also musically speaking today.
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. You know, my dad was in a band in Kosovo, and you know, hearing his music, his songs, his love for music, and the way that he was so passionate about it, that was always very inspiring to me. And you know, when I moved to Kosovo, it was very, like, people listened to so much hip-hop. But there was also, like, Albanian artists. There was this one rap group and they were called NR. And they were my favorite. They were my favorite because, and I didn't really have like a song in particular. They had one album, which was called Ejeli, and it means the angel of death. And it was, I guess they were kind of the first rappers with like a real social conscience. And like the stuff that they spoke about was very politically charged. And they were talking about the oppression during the war and what was going on. So it was, I feel like it was quite like a, I don't know, like a groundbreaking moment almost in Albanian rap, where they were so straightforward and so explicit. And I feel like that really paved the way for a lot of other artists. And so I feel like that also, I guess, inspired me a lot. You know, I lived there from the age of 11 to 15.
It's 6 o'clock, the news with David Addis. News is just coming in of an explosion at a building in the town centre. Initially, the radical group NR were blamed for the blast, but they deny all responsibility. No one was injured in the incident, though a parrot lost all its feathers. Ngoni mirë, se që këj nuk o test. Me hi ma fell, ti t'es. Shoj ku se prep, mikrofoni e kun trek. Une nuk vet se as nuk pres. Po kom rima me fes, e te ti, unë I shes. Ti, kur ti njën hin stres. Ma njëri se nuk o test. Për të si në MC, ju hala nuk I njën ni. Ju e dine që nga për të pohi. Tërsa ti njën di tri. Une ju vet e kumi u shti.
Ever concert was Method Man and Redman because they were the only people to come to Pristina.
I worked with them once.
You did?
Yeah, that's I booked them for the Prada Foundation, Fondazione Prada, during in Miami.
That's so sick. I mean, that was my first introduction to Wu-Tang Clan, and I was, I can't remember, maybe like 12, 13 years old.
Yeah,
and I was just, best. It was just amazing, you know. So many parts of my life are very much intertwined between my life growing up in London and then life in Kosovo. Doc, where the weed at, bitch? I speed backwards down the one way from cops. See that shit? Believe that shit. Snorter, straight the camcorder. I'm too hot for TV. Rap, draw water. My windpipes attached to project ballers. You yell, turn the heat down. My voice, DVD round sound. Some herd round town. And chances of y'all leaving round now. Wait later, we'll make front page paper. Date rape up with juvenile eighth graders. Hit the high school in 187 Caesar. When I bust, y'all need the back 4 acres. Well, that's why,
obviously, knowing your heritage, because I'm, you know, Persian, born in Germany. Mm. And I love asking my guests who have an interesting background, because sometimes you don't hear that story. And I personally find it very interesting, especially because I'm so into world music. And yeah. Actually, I love Albanian music as well.
Oh,
you know,
cool.
I was playing stuff 2 seasons ago all summer, you know, contemporary Albanian pop. Yeah. Yeah, it's so colorful, you know, it makes it so much more interesting also to you learn a whole different perspective about you.
Absolutely.
Person you speak to, you know.
Absolutely, I believe
Yeah,
that.
I mean, it all merges. Well, which leads me to my next question. How would you describe yourself with 3 non-DL songs?
That's hard.
It's a tricky one. I know.
It's a really...
It's not definite. Yeah,
yeah, I guess it's mm-hmm. It's a hard... It's also, I guess, the way, like, you kind of perceive the question. A way to describe myself in 3 non-DL songs. Okay. Feel Good by The Gorillaz. Just because I love that song. I love how it makes me feel. I feel like, you know, feeling good is a big part of my life. You know, I love to do things that make me happy, make me feel proud, make me want to have fun, that kind of stuff. Like, I love that. All for that.
Did you ever see them live?
No, I haven't seen them live. And I really wish I had the opportunity to, at least for those like earlier albums as well. It's amazing. And yeah. So no, I haven't had the chance to do that, but hopefully
I'm sure
at one point that would be cool. Said it's breaking down on a camel's back. They just have to go because they don't know where. So while you fill the streets, it's appealing to see. You won't get on the county because you're dead and free. You got a new horizon, it's ephemeral style. A melancholy town where we never smile. And all I want to hear is the message beep. My dreams, they got a kiss because I don't get sleep, no. Windmill, windmill for the land. The forever hand in hand. Take it all out on your stride. It is taking for all. Music by Madonna rules my life, you know, music and everything that that, you know, brings me and what I love to do. And it's a massive part of who I am.
Also just work with, right?
Yes, I did also just work with her, which was unreal, which is super amazing. But I guess before we get onto that, there's this song by this new artist who I love called Erica DeCassia, and she's got a song called Do My Thing, and it's very just like in your face, I'm having fun, I'm doing my thing, like don't bother me, I'm on my own like wave. That's I think those three songs describe me. I mean, honestly, it's like a mountain of songs that really have shaped me and that I feel have played such a massive role in my life. I just wanna do my thing, go to the club till the early morning, jump around like ain't nobody watching, I don't really care that my baby calling. I just wanna ease my pain, no I blame nobody, no one, no shame. I wanna move my body, that's why I came, and if you're not down, get out of my way. Song title wise, song content wise, musically, I feel like those are really fun that I think explain my personality also.
Great choices.
Thank you.
I like it. Didn't know the last one. I can't wait to hear it.
Oh, you have to check it out. It's amazing.
Yeah. Well, we'll be hearing it.
We're going to mix it sick, in. Sick.
Yeah. Afterwards, I'll edit it all in. Well, before we jump to Madonna, because I kind of jumped the questions here, but going back to your album and disco, obviously, as I mentioned earlier on, you know, it's our mutual love is disco. And, you know, we were talking about, you know, doing fun little events and parties. Do you have a record that or an artist that influenced you for that future nostalgia, like disco sound? They were like, oof, I want to create this kind of vibe.
Well, for the record, I had influences like Blondie, Jamiroquai, Moloko. Those were like the pinnacle for me. But also that those were like influences, again, music that my parents had listened to at home. Yeah. But there are so many incredible disco songs like that I just love. I mean, it's like the list can go on forever. I mean, from like Staying Alive, Bee Gees, to Bad Girls, Donna Summer, to Dancing Queen, ABBA, to Heart of Glass, Blondie, which is my eternal classic. It's, you know, there's so many, and they're all so different and so unique, and I feel every single song really paints a different picture, and it's just so fun to listen to. So disco lives on forever.
Definitely. I mean, I love that, you know, also you having a younger audience kind of bringing back that feel, because it's an upper, you know, it's very positive. And it's nice, especially in today's world, bringing color, I think, is so important.
Absolutely.
You know? I heard this new term, which I fell in love with, radical optimism.
Whoa, I love that.
I know.
Radical optimism.
Radical optimism.
That's exactly what we need in the world, is radical optimism. I love that.
Exactly. It's my slogan for 2020.
Wow, I'll
radical be... Radical optimism.
I'll be fucking taking
new,
that one.
It's a new title.
Hell yeah. That's such a great thing to embrace.
Totally. So just waving that flag of optimism. And I love your record. I have to say, it's fun. You can, you know, I when I saw it and I heard it, I was like, let's go dance. You know, like that's what you want.
Yes.
Great. And
thank
I love
you.
The club.
Thank
the
you
club,
so much.
The club remixes.
Future, you know, Nostalgia like remix. Future. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, Moody Man, sick.
name like I have never heard before. I'm indecisive, but this time I know for sure. I hope I'm not the only one that feels it all. Are you falling?
I know. Oh my God. It was such a mind-blowing experience to get to work with all those incredible producers and artists, and it was surreal, you know, and the whole process of like asking different artists like if it was okay that we sample these tracks and going through the clearing process, and everybody seemed so on board. It was such a massive collective effort, and I learned so much about dance music, and it felt very nostalgic to be able to kind of remix a record as a whole where you listen it from the beginning till the end. And it just gives you so many different moods and energies and people, and it was such a dream come true. And it was kind of thanks to the time, you know, because never in a million years I feel like I would never find those people sitting at home while we were all in lockdown. And to be able to create something like that.
When did you ask them?
I guess the project kind of started, so we went into lockdown in March in the UK. I think probably around like April, we started putting feelers out.
Yeah.
And seeing what people thought. But I was already in contact, for example, with the Blessed Madonna, Maria, who...
my dear, shout out to Maria.
We love Maria. who I actually met through Mark Ronson at Glastonbury, which was a whole trip. That was super fun. And she, of course, also remixed Electricity that I did with Silk City with Mark Ronson and Diplo. And the kind of relationship just, like, blossomed from that point on. And, yeah, oh, my God, it was just amazing. Just kind of bouncing off ideas with her, learning so much from her and who she thought we should pair songs with different, you know, producers and artists and DJs. And I was like, this is mind-blowing. This is amazing, you know, to have someone help you curate your music, you know, in a completely different light was amazing to me. And I loved the whole experience. Of course, you know, back to Madonna and Missy Elliott.
Another Madonna, yeah.
You know, another Madonna. My idols, you know, artists that I've listened to my whole life, that I've looked up to, that I've listened to their music, that have soundtracked so many moments in my life, that I then had the opportunity to, like, reach out and be like, hey, like, I'm doing this curated dance record, and I was wondering if you wanted to, like, join in. And they were so down for it and, you know, lovely. And it was amazing. You know, the experience was great. And I'm just so happy to have something to really bring this whole thing together. It was cool. Let's go. Boy, I'm advanced, got my real tight pants. When I back it up, I put you in the trance. If you want to dance, then show me all your bands, because tonight I might give you that chance. Let's get it. Skirt. Pull up in the coupe. Ooh, that dude, he look hella cute. Yeah, he looking at me like, ooh, say my breasts like Betty Boo. Oh, my. Get the stuttering like, I. I'm a freak, I like to play shy, but I will get it popping, anything, I'll try it. Say I'm on this top five list, on a major key like Kylie. Don't sleep, open up your eyelids. I can be your girl if you keep it private. You want me, I want you, baby. My sugar boo, I'm levitating.
It's great. It's literally like a DJ set. You know, I listen to on Spotify, which usually is like pick and choose, right? You pick your tracks you like, but you can actually listen from beginning to end because it's like a set.
Exactly. You know? And you got to do your little fade out setting. So exactly, it just slowly goes into the other one.
Yes. Highly recommended. Did you, I guess, I mean, everything was online, but did you meet Missy or Madonna before?
No, I didn't. I had phone calls with them, which was cool.
Sick.
But hopefully at some point I'll get to, like, hang out with them in person, you know, when the time comes.
Get them involved live performances.
That would be fun.
Well, we did talk about your Albanian heritage.
Yeah.
But is that like a particular record or track from today that you would like to put out that did you like or you discovered recently in your Spotify?
I think, again, like going back to NR, they were such like amazing rap group. Like I love them and I always feel like I go back to them and I reference them. But in general, you know, I love Albanian music so much. And, you know, we do a festival in Kosovo, which obviously has international artists, but also domestic artists as well. And it's so amazing to have, you know, when like internationals come and like they're watching the show and they're singing in a completely different language, but everybody can speak music, you know, it's something that always brings you together, no matter what. It was exactly what you were, you know, explaining and describing. And I think that's such a beautiful thing that music is so universal in that way. So yeah, it's beautiful.
That's what I love about world music. I mean, I don't speak 80% of the languages that I'm listening to, but you just feel it.
Yeah, yeah.
If the production is good, if there's heart behind it, you don't have to understand. You just get it.
100%.
Well, first of all, Happy New Year.
Oh, Happy New Year. I'm here with a Korean juice.
Yeah.
I'm taking January very seriously.
Yes, yes. Me too.
What is that? What are you drinking?
A little spritz, Light
oh,
spirits.
How fancy. It's still midday here. So
I know.
We're at very different points of the day. So don't judge me with my green juice.
Not at all. This is LA. You start with the green juice in the morning and yeah, with another green juice at night, which is more like cucumber infused.
Yes.
But this is also to you, a cheers to you to 2054.
Oh.
What a huge success.
Thank you so much. Cheers. That was an incredible experience.
Major.
Thank you. That was a lot of fun, you know, to after missing live shows and not being able to perform and postpone my tour twice, because I feel like when you say cancel, it almost makes it definite and you want it to be postponed because I'm dying. I'm ready for us to get out to perform these songs and to tour and to have had the opportunity to do it in a really safe way in London. You know, I was in London for 2 months rehearsing every single day. I wanted it to be perfect. I wanted to like do everything. Like I wanted it to just be seamless. And because we were just doing it all in a warehouse and we had to run through all the marks and make sure that everything just kind of hit at the right time. It was a lot of fun. It was crazy. And you know, the energy was something that we all had missed so much. So yeah, it was a milestone moment and something that, I don't know, was just so interesting because it was something that I'd never, you know, done before. It was a whole new way of doing performances. And it's something that I guess, you know, we're all figuring out.
You guys set the tone, a complete new tone with it. I mean, the numbers were incredible. Something like what, 5 to 8 million viewers?
It was crazy actually, but it still sounds insane that many people watched the show. But I guess that's the power of, you know, the internet and, you know, when people do have it accessible at home. And I mean, I don't, you know, I'm hoping that the future of music and live music all comes back. I feel like we're all missing that quite a lot, that kind of human connection. But I do feel like in some way these live stream shows will also continue because they also do open so many doors, I feel, for, you know, being able to create like interesting creatives that you wouldn't necessarily be able to do on a stage or in an arena or, you know, a club show or whatever. You know, with sets you have a very, of course you're creating a world, but it's still very limited, whereas you have the space to walk around and create different moments. That's also, you know, fun and something that I might keep doing even if I do, you know, go back on tour. I really enjoyed it. So it was...
Yeah, I think you guys kicked something off there because obviously live music is going to come back eventually.
Yeah.
And, but the, I mean, because we kind of have a whole new awareness to technology and how we experience and how we consume.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, the past few months really forced us to learn certain skills. I mean, hello, Zoom, for instance.
My God.
I've heard of Zoom before.
Exactly. Now everyone's got Zoom on their phones, their laptops, we're obsessed with it.
Yeah.
House party, everything. You know, everyone's on
everything.
The FaceTime, weddings. We're on it. Weddings, yeah. There's so much going on.
So yeah, I think there's definitely also looking at the success. I mean, we were talking about paying viewership, right? So that's definitely going to stay. And I think that's going to be an interesting next few months, years, where it's going to be some sort of hybrid. Let's see. So again, kudos to you and your team.
Thank you. Thank you. I'll pass on the message. They're all very proud, so it's good.
Was there like a moment that stuck with you from the performance that you're like,
oh? I mean, I had so many pinch me moments. I was so lucky to have all those incredible artists join me. You know, I had FKA Twigs, I had Kylie Minogue, I had the Blessed Madonna, I had Elton John, J Balvin, Bad Bunny, Tiny, Miley. You know, all these artists just kind of, everybody wanted to come in and join in. And I had Angèle as well, who's...
Angèle.
I love her.
I really love Angèle.
I love her. So it was just an incredible experience. And I feel like those were a massive highlight, you know, coming together, doing all the dancing. That was something that I really had to work so hard on to make sure that I just did, you know, I was able to sing and dance at the same time. And that was a highlight. The outfits were a highlight for me. I have to say, I love a dress up. So,
were some of our girls from the Attico, right? You had some.
Yeah, I had my first outfit was Attico, and then I loved my final look, the Mugler. It was like a chandelier type body piece. It was fun. I loved it. It was an experience.
Well, when we're back on track and reality is back, and we're going out and getting ready for a night out, or before the lockdown, do you have like a go-to getting ready song like that gets you into the mood?
I do. Actually, there's this, have you heard Yummy by Gwen Stefani? She did it with Pharrell. It was like a while ago. And it's like, I'm feeling yummy head to toe. That's the song. That's the one I want to play when I'm getting ready to go out. That's the one.
Sing it again.
I'm feeling yummy head to toe.
I'm feeling yummy head to toe. You see me, ain't got no patience, so let's go. You see me, look, I'm diet drama. Wanna spend the night, don't bring pajamas. Man, there's so much heat beneath these clothes. You see me, walk in the place. They know my face. Encore, sophomore, only one solo, I swore. Big mouth, applause, oh please, one more. Wanna hear it before, say nah. Let me check my itinerary, all right.
It's so good, she just kills it. She's so like... I don't know, she just flows, she's got so much attitude, it's fun, it's sexy, she just goes for it, I love it. It's definitely gets you in the mood.
I love it. Well, to go slightly more intimate, what's your go-to heartbreak or falling in love song?
I don't really have a go-to song in that way, but have you seen that movie Layer Cake?
Yes, UK classic.
And there's that scene where Sienna Miller's in the club and she's like smoking her cigarette and she's like dancing and Daniel Craig like can't get her eyes off her, and there's like a very lustful moment. And then You Got the Love is playing by The Source and Candy Stanton, and I feel like that moment, that's like a falling in love kind of song, because I when that song plays, it's all I can picture is the movie. So I'm gonna say that one.
Very good choice.
Thank you.
And let's say you fall in love, there's going to be a heartbreak, but then you're feeling better again, you're out and about, and you're feeling sexy.
You're ready to go.
You're ready to go. What's the sexiest song?
Sexiest song is, and I go back to this song a lot because I've always loved it sonically and lyrically, and I think it's an amazing song, is Touch by Rai.
Mm.
You know that one?
We love Rai.
So yeah, good. I love that one. That's a sexy song.
I'm not awake. I'm not alone. You're right beside my face. Will you love me this way? 'Cause I'm dancing with my eyes closed. It's okay, it's me, babe. One more time for my taste. One more time for my taste.
central and beautiful. It's so Sade-like.
Yeah, exactly. It's very Sade-like. I feel like also anything Sade is very sexy. Ordinary Love, I feel like that is the ultimate sexiest song. So maybe I'll have to throw that one in as well.
I gave you all the love I got. I gave you more than I could give. Gave you love. I gave you all that I have inside. And you took my love. You took my love. Didn't I tell you?
I mean, I guess you haven't seen her perform live, have you?
No. But
probably, because the last time she was 2010. So yeah, it's a bit of a long time. I haven't seen her live either.
Well, to wrap up our little chat,
if your life would be a movie, what song would play in the end credits?
This is the hardest question on planet Earth.
You'll be surprised the answers I get.
So, really?
Yeah.
Well, I feel like I need to give you something funny. Because everything, I feel like I've been very serious on all of them and very, like, straight to the point. No, okay. Piece of Me by Britney Spears.
You want a piece of me, Ben Meaty.
No, I'm joking. But we can throw that in. But I feel like Pursuit of Happiness, Kid Cudi, is, like, the perfect end credit song. Because you're always on that. You're always on that path, I feel. So I'm just going to... I'm gonna leave it at that.
I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that's shining always gonna be gold. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that's shining always gonna be gold. I'll be fine.
And I like how we're ending. We start with happiness and positivity, and then it ends on positivity.
Yeah, it does. It's definitely a slower pace, but it's still a beautiful song, and I think it's chef's kiss. It's a chef's kiss at the end.
It's a chef's kiss. Kid Cudi's a lot at a Chateau, so if you see him,
oh, he is?
Grab him. Yeah.
I'll be like, man, you know, I did say that if my life was a movie, I'd choose your song to be in the end credits.
Well, Dua, it's been a real pleasure.
Thank you. Likewise. And hopefully I'll see you soon. Maybe stateside, maybe in Europe. Who knows? Let's see how the world.
Are you coming back?
No, I'm staying in LA at least until after the Grammys, and then we'll see.
They got postponed this year, right?
Like, yeah, they were meant to be end of January, and now they're March 14th.
March.
Yeah, so I'll be here for a few months.
Well, it's looking good. You're killing it. It's your year.
Let's not jinx it. But thank you.
Oh, and congrats on the Rolling Stones cover.
Oh, thank you so much. That was a lot of fun. That was a crazy, surreal moment working with David LaChapelle as well. What a legend. So I'm grateful.
He's
for
gonna be on the series too.
He is?
Yeah.
Legendary. Love it. Tell him I love him. And thank you so much. I love this.
Thank you, Dua.
Have a good night. Enjoy your spritz.
Have a good morning.
Mwah.
Enjoy your juice.
See ya. Ciao.
Thank you for tuning in this week. If you want to listen to the full playlist, visit areweonair.com or our Spotify channel. You can also find us on Instagram and on YouTube at areweonair. And a big thank you to my wonderful team at Studio Noi. I'm Arman Nafei, and I'll speak to you soon.